answer your question, the first thing I want to clarify is what is the legal definition of data breach? Because I think the common idea is when you have a data breach, it's usually malware or an outside force breaking into your data center. Even a bank's vault is capable of being prone to data breach. Because when you talk about personal information or personal data, it's both manual and electronic. That being said, as long as there are three standards for you to determine whether or not there's a data breach: integrity, confidentiality, and availability. As long as, once any of those standards are affected, then you have a data breach. So hacking is not the top, is not the number one cause of a data breach. Actually, the number one cause is employee negligence and or malfeasance. So in fact, I was about to get there a while ago, but this one, some of the short stories I wanted to share was, for example, a few years back, Starbucks was fined by the FTC millions of dollars, hundreds of millions of dollars, because one employee misplaced a laptop in their own coffee shop. And that laptop was not secure, it was not encrypted, and it was easily accessed. So a lot of people were subjected to identity theft, fraud, etc., etc. So that's a data breach. So it's usually misplaced electronics. Another, the second and third are actually unsecure mobile devices and cloud technology. So apparently cloud, I think before AWS touted the idea of sufficiently encrypted cloud technology, you had previous cloud services that were insecure or unsecure. That's why there were a lot of breaches. Hacking is actually number four. Unfortunately, I don't remember number five, it's in my laptop. But number four is hacking or not. So, hinuli ko na yun para hindi niyo ako mapagalitan. So there, I hope I answered your question. For your question, sorry, you, what your name is?
Reginald.
So, who can actually complain for violation of data privacy act is the data subject.
No, sir. Like, for example, our public figures, for example, like the president can invoke data privacy act.
Depends on what he is invoking. So, for example, if you're invoking data privacy for you not to disclose information that you are mandated to provide under the law, you cannot invoke data privacy. So, for example, I'll give an example, and I think, I don't speak for the National Privacy Commission, but I think based on their last statement, for example, your SALN for government officials, you can't use the Data Privacy Act to say you cannot disclose the amount of real estate that you officially own. You can't even block addresses. Why? Because that's specifically enumerated under the law. So you can't use the Data Privacy Act and say, no, I can't do that. What the president can do is, for example, his personal information, something that's provided in the SALN was used by, let's say, another government official or CSC, the Civil Service Commission, used that data for something else that's not contemplated under the law. The purpose of the SALN is basically lifestyle checks. It's to ensure that whatever your income is reflects whatever your interests are. Now, if that information in your SALN is used not related to that, then he can complain because that's his data. And as far as he knows, you're only collecting and processing it based on what the law requires. You go beyond that, you've already violated unauthorized the rule against unauthorized access to personal information, which has a fine and imprisonment. So it really depends on what you're invoking. If it's unauthorized use, anyone can, a public official can, but it really depends on what the basis is. So, companies cannot, because companies are not data subjects. Only natural persons are data subjects.